What's up, guys, and good morning. We have got something in store for you guys today. I'm not gonna like fully give it away, but I am gonna say Allie, myself, Leo, just those three, are going to pick up Joel, and we are going to have a lot of fun. I can't really tell you anything else without giving too much away, but there's just a lot of snow out there. We are gonna be escaping the snow, and the first thing that I'm gonna be doing today is something that Allie has been begging for, and it's not completely shaving off my beard, but I'm gonna knock it down quite a bit. One thing that I always hate about shaving my beard is that my beard grows and it starts to get really long under my chin. And then I just start to like kind of identify my face as being longer than it actually is. And then when I shave off my chin, I like feel like my face is all weird and scrunched, but probably looks a little sharper. And where we're going, it's not necessarily gonna be winter. So beard should probably come off a little bit anyway. Also, we seem to have another problem. When it gets really warm in the morning time and the sun comes up and Allie and I are trying to sleep in and Leo is sleeping perfectly and just nothing could go wrong, all of a sudden we keep hearing this and nothing will happen for like another 30 seconds to 5 minutes, and then and we're like, is that a woodpecker? Like, what? I don't know, maybe the camera picked that up, maybe not. At first I thought it was like some wood expanding and contracting and like causing some vibration or something, which like sounds far-fetched, but also the outside of our house consists solely of concrete and metal. Like, there's no wood out there. So, and there's trees everywhere. So why would a woodpecker be pecking at our house when he could be pecking at his beloved wood that's growing all over the place? Like, it doesn't make any sense to me. I guess the positive side of this thing is to just think that our house looks so much like wood, even though it's concrete, that even a woodpecker can be fooled. And hopefully he doesn't make any holes in the concrete. Maybe he just pecks it a few times and says, yuck, that's not wood. I don't know. We've got our hopes high. Anyway, I'm gonna go jump in the shower. Allie's getting ready.
Early starts are not our thing anymore ever since we've had a baby, but we're not actually running that far behind, and I think we have everything we need staged. Now it just needs to make its way from the living room to the car without dropping anything in the mud.
We've got all of this stuff. We're heading down to the valley. We're not gonna tell you guys where we're going yet.
Little by little, piece by piece, I take back what's been stolen from me. Little by little, piece by piece, until I'm complete.
Do we have everything?
Nobody knows.
So we're going on vacation, if you guys couldn't tell by now, and we are going to have a lot of fun. And Frank is going with us right now, but that's because he's going to Grandma and Grandpa's house. And we're trying to do like the triple check to make sure we've got everything. And we probably don't, but hopefully whatever we're forgetting is not gonna be too impactful. So we are heading out the door right now. We're about to jump in the 4Runner. We're heading down to the valley to drop off Frank. And then we're going to pick up Joel.
Oh, Frank. Oh boy. Go potty. Come on, Frank, let's go.
How you doing?
Is that a new kind of kennel?
No, it's just dog food.
How are you?
Where's the boss?
He's still out there, I think. Oh, you mean the baby?
Yeah.
He's sleeping in the car.
Oh.
We have some really fun plans that we've set up over the last few months. It's been really just like a ton of logistics, a lot of moving parts, a lot of people involved. It's hopefully all gonna come together and be a super fun family trip. But for right now, it's kind of in that like in between, like, did we forget anything? Does everybody have their tickets? Is everything gonna work?
Yeah.
Hopefully it's all gonna work. Frank is going to be happy and on his own little vacation here with Grandma and Grandpa. They are really excited to take care of him while we're gone. And next stop, we got to get Joel.
He'll be okay?
Yeah, and I'll watch this guy like a hawk.
Okay, good.
Because he'll be slipping a little English muffin and toad.
That's right.
Don't even be thinking about airplanes or what airplane they're on or anything like that.
JetBlue is a little cheaper, Aunt Kathy told me.
Yeah.
We really appreciate it.
Oh, pretty.
All right, we'll talk to you soon. If there's any problems, just give us a call.
Yeah. What are you gonna do about it?
Tell you we're sorry.
Bye, Frank. Love you guys.
Thank you.
Bye,
Dad. It is a huge blessing to be able to have my grandparents there to help us with Frank and sometimes with Lika, but now that Lika's big and just a little bit of a handful for my grandparents. They don't ever take Lika, but Lika's at boarding school right now, so they're gonna take Frank. He's gonna have probably the best time of his life. He's gonna come back 20 pounds heavier, I guarantee it, because my grandpa has a problem with feeding the dog. But anyway, now we're on our way to pick up Joel.
Joel.
Hi.
Hi.
Are you excited?
So hopefully I can sleep in the car ride.
For sure. Lika is still on summer break. She's having a grand old time. Frank is with Grandma and Grandpa. We've got Leo packed up in the car, and now we've got Joel as well. Before we actually hit the road, we've been trying to hit the road all morning. I'm assuming, Joel, well, I don't know. Are you hungry? Joel's hungry. So we've been waiting because we figured if we got food, as soon as we picked up Joel, he would want some food. So we're gonna go somewhere and grab something delicious to take on the road with us.
Now that you've had some time to reflect, what were the most memorable parts of the trip?
Thanks, Doug.
It's memorable for me too. Second, we got unstuck. Joel was like, "All right, we're going back now," and I was like, "No, we're going forward, bro." And he's like, "What?" He's like, "We just got unstuck. Like, we were almost gonna die out here." And I was like,
"Yeah,
but
we're out. Like, all right, we turn around now." He's like, "Nah."
I was like, "What?" It's classic.
Type 2 fed.
My wife's car, so I can't really do anything too gnarly.
Is that what he would say?
Yeah, because people are like, "Come on, dude, do Hell's Gate." I'm like, I can't.
My wife car.
If anything happens, my wife will kill me.
Alright, thank you.
Thank you. You too. So yeah, we went to Wendy's. It's not necessarily our first choice of food, but we are in a hurry. It's right off the freeway, and now we're jumping back on the freeway. We've got about a 6-hour drive today, and basically the end of today, we're gonna be ending in Las Vegas. We are almost to Vegas. We're about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours away.
Hello.
How was it?
I almost bought ice cream for everyone.
That's a terrible idea.
That's how hot it is right now.
All we've eaten is like Wendy's.
I didn't do it. I almost did it.
Yeah, so it's like probably 80 something degrees here. And by the time we get to Vegas, it's probably supposed to be like 90 degrees. So summer is well on its way down here, even though there's snow at our house. It feels really good down here. And yeah, it's got me really excited for like green grass and trees with leaves and
there's none of that
lemonade and like, you know, hanging out in the sun. I'm excited for summer, but anyway, we're gonna jump back on the road. We'll be to Vegas shortly.
Leo was getting fussy and making noises, and Joel just repeated those noises back to him. Leo was like, "Whoa! Oh man!"
Thank you. This welcome to the Las Vegas Boulevard Strip.
This is Treasure Island right here. There's a big pirate show that goes on here, like every however often.
Oh yeah, so much of the experience of Las Vegas is literally just walking around because there's like fountains and shows and just so much to look at. And it's gorgeous, especially at night. It is 91 degrees outside, so it definitely won't get super cold tonight. We used to come here a lot with friends over New Year's, and it was always like freezing. So my most recent memories of Vegas are always that it's really, really cold. But I think tonight it's gonna be like beautiful and crisp. It'll hopefully go down in temperature a little bit, and we'll be able to really show Joel around. Do you see up ahead, there's a building that says Hell's Kitchen in red letters? On the right. Hell's Kitchen is the name of the Gordon Ramsay restaurant.
One of them.
One of Gordon Ramsay's restaurants.
Got like five in Vegas.
Do you know who Gordon Ramsay is?
I do, of course.
Of course, sorry. We may or may not be attending that venue later on tonight.
All right, we made it through the lobby experience. We got our keys, we got our room number. Are you guys ready to have some fun?
So much fun.
All right, well, we're gonna go check out the room, get dropped off, and then we're heading to dinner.
Wow. Wow, open her up, let us take a look.
That's a cool view.
That's the pool.
That's the pool?
Oh, really? For this?
Wow.
Nice.
Unfortunately, we're not going to be going to the pool. We're not going to be going on the Ferris wheel. We're not even, we're really just staying here for a night because it was a good spot to stay on the way. Probably a foolish decision to stay like on the strip when we're just passing through for one night.
But Joel has never been to Vegas, so we had no choice but to give him at least a small Vegas experience.
We're going to get ready and head to dinner. Alright, so we're here at Hell's Kitchen now. For those of you guys that know Gordon Ramsay's restaurant, Hell's Kitchen, there's a TV show on it, and a lot of the cooks that win the TV show actually end up working in this restaurant. I've been here once before and it was absolutely amazing. We've got Joel here, he's gonna be trying some of the food.
I'm really excited. I've never been here. I've only heard Trent talk about it. So it's Joel and I and Leo's first experience. Leo's just gonna observe. Joel and I are very excited to try out the food.
Without further ado, some delicious food. Really good? Yeah. It's fantastic.
That's
the
scariest seat ever had. Yeah, it's really good.
Intense.
You've been preparing for the speed walking competition your entire life.
Yeah, I was performing greatly, as you can tell. You're having the time of your life. But needless to say, we made it safely back to the hotel. We're gonna go inside, hit the sack. We'll see you guys in the morning. It is day two of our extravaganza here. We have just woke up here in Vegas. Leo is having a wonderful time on his first hotel bed. Yeah, look at how happy you are. Well, Allie has gone to get some ice so that she can put some of Leo's milk on ice while we get back into the car. Like I said, we're just spending an overnight here in Vegas. This was basically just an intermediate point because this morning we're loading back into the 4Runner and we're all heading to LA. I don't know if you guys can guess what we're gonna be doing there. We're gonna be meeting some special guests there later today. It's a big surprise because none of the people coming have any idea why they're coming, but it's gonna be really exciting. They have no idea. You're the only one that knows, Joel.
Yeah, I realize that. I forgot about that.
Anyway, we're gonna get packed up. We're hitting the road.
Vegas in the morning is like a club that turns the lights on at the end of the night. It's completely empty. There's nobody around.
Everyone's
it's just like
sweeping things.
Yeah, everyone's, yeah, there's like janitors and people like picking up trash. It's like very deserted and eerie. So at 7 a.m., it was like us and a couple employees in the casino of the hotel. That's about it. We actually are way on time, which is a huge plus this morning. I always expect us to be running late, but we are ahead of schedule. We got a short little dose of Vegas, which is basically the exact polar opposite of where we're heading right now, which was perfect. And we have a couple more hours of driving, and then we're gonna meet some really fun people. All right. Taking a quick pit stop to fill up on gas, to go to the bathroom, and I'm using this time to reapply some sunscreen. It's really important for both me and Trent to take care of our skin, especially with how light Trent's skin is. He burns really easily. You've heard us talk about Native before. Native is the sponsor of today's video, and they have a sunscreen product that we absolutely love. Not only does Native have deodorant and body wash, but their sunscreen is top quality. It feels lightweight, absorbs quickly, and goes on sheer without leaving any white residue behind. With SPF 30 coverage, it protects against UVA and UVB rays. Available in coconut and pineapple, rosé, and unscented. It's dermatologist tested, non-nano zinc, made with 97% plant-based ingredients, and just like their other products, it's vegan and cruelty-free. Native wants to make sure you're taking care of your skin. That's why they're giving you an incredible deal. If you click our link in the description, you'll actually get 30% off the face and body sunscreen. Normally it's $36, but you guys can get both products for just $25 if you use our code, click the link below. It's so easy to take care of your skin, and it's so, so important. So check them out. Thanks again to Native for sponsoring today's video. We are going to lather up, hit the road, and pick you guys up in a little bit.
You know, it's so interesting. We're actually in LA or LA County right now. We're kind of funneling our way down towards Anaheim, which is a city that we're going to right now to pick up a rental car so that we can pick up our special guests. Things are crazy, and what's that game where you like drop a little ball and it like bounces on the pegs, makes its way down? You know what I'm talking about?
I do. I don't know the name of it.
I don't either, but it's like a super old-timey game for video games. And that's what I always feel like scattering through LA. In Salt Lake City, there's basically like two main freeways. There's I-15 and I-215 or I-80. So like, there's not a lot of options for how to get to different places without taking side streets. In LA, there's like 25 different freeways, and they're all going different directions, and they're all loaded with traffic, some of them worse than others. But like, I feel like that little ball right now, just like bouncing through the pegs, trying to make our way down towards the beach. We're really excited for why we're here. We're really excited to meet the people that we're going to be meeting here. They land in like an hour or 2 hours. They land in about 2 hours, so we got to pick up our rental car, go to LAX, and meet them at the airport.
We grabbed the rental car and we made it to LAX. Now, the reason that we're here is to meet my sister Jennifer and her six kids. They live in Wisconsin, and for their spring break, we planned this huge surprise for them. They just landed and they should be heading out any minute.
Of course, this is the most nerve-wracking part. We're just waiting for them to come out. They don't know we're here, and they should be out any minute. Jennifer just texted us. Obviously, Jennifer knows the whole plan. She is the one that we've been coordinating and planning all this with for months now. But the kids don't know anything, so we're excited to surprise the kids. Hopefully they're surprised, honestly. And they should be walking out right now. Hello? Emotional. I get emotional like that. Jules! Oh my gosh!
light?
Hi, it's so good to see you.
No.
It's good.
Is it intense?
It's kind of, it was our first flight.
Yeah.
So it's like,
you made it.
We're still alive, so I guess it went okay.
Good, good.
All right, so we have, the Eagle has landed. Basically, my sister and all of her kids have finally landed here at LAX. We are loading up into the two cars. We're making a stop at the grocery store because we've got to feed everybody for like 8 days. We've got to go to like Walmart or somewhere and load up on just pounds and pounds of food, and then we're heading to the Airbnb.
All right, so we've got Ben and Sarah in the car. Where, what do you think we're doing here?
I don't know.
I have no idea.
This is it. Welcome to paradise. This is like that Homer Simpson meme where he like backs into the bushes.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Did you just pull?
Ooh.
Oh, cool! Let me out!
What do you think?
It's awesome.
All right, so we've made it back to the Airbnb. I've tried to get an introduction from everybody, but there's some Shire people in the group.
Hello, I'm Jennifer.
Hey, I'm Sarah.
Hi, I'm Grace.
What's up, y'all? I'm Ben.
I'm Blake.
Am I going too?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm Joel.
I'm Allie.
This Airbnb is really cool. There's a pool out back. There's a pool table, so everybody's enjoying some pool. Allie and my sister Jennifer are whipping up some tacos for tonight for dinner. It's nice to be on vacation. But they are all wondering why they just flew halfway across the United States. Basically nobody here except for Joel and my sister Jennifer and Allie and I know where we're going or what we're doing.
Sophie thought maybe it was a wedding. It's not a wedding.
I thought it was kind of fun.
Oh! I thought we were just coming here to swim.
That's part of it. You're halfway right. So I don't know if you know that California has a bunch of really fun activities that I've only gotten to experience once in my life. Some people never get to experience them, and we thought it would be really fun for you guys to experience all of them. So this week, we're doing Disney, we're doing Universal Studios, and we're doing another theme park.
We're gonna go and see Elsa.
But for tonight, we're gonna eat dinner, we're gonna relax, we have a very big day ahead of us tomorrow, and we're gonna let these guys process what they're even doing here.
We'll see you guys in the morning.
Oh, good morning, guys. We have been having so much fun with Jennifer and the kids. It's honestly been a vacation. We don't really take vacations that often, and it feels so nice to just hang out, relax, spend some quality time with them. We don't get to see them very often, and honestly, that was the main motivation for us being on this trip with them. Every summer, almost, they make the trip out from Wisconsin, where they live, to Utah, but then when they're in Utah, they have so many family to see and so many activities, and their itinerary is packed. So we never get to spend more than like a meal together, and we haven't really seen them and spent quality time together in 4 or 5 years. We thought this trip would be a really nice way to have some real bonding time, for Joel to spend time with his cousins. They don't get to see each other that often. Everything has been going really well. We're just having a blast. Leo has been giggling up a storm, hanging out with his cousins, and today we're just waking up bright and early. It's about 7 a.m. We're getting packed up. We're heading to one of the most exciting parks of our adventures this week.
Everybody got up this morning, we had a little bit of coffee, everybody's having some cereal. I think everybody's starting to get amped up for Disneyland. We've been talking about it a little bit, and most of Jennifer's kids don't even really know what to expect. 10 years ago, Joel and I were at Disneyland. We spent 2 days there, and it was awesome, and I remember a lot of things changed from when I was 7, and now it's been, you know, 10 years later, so probably quite a few more things that have changed now. So we're all excited, we're getting ready, and we're heading to Disneyland.
so don't let me go now. It's funny because even though we're not like actually blood related, you have my hair. That's exactly what my hair used to look like. Except my mom always had like a buzz cut, like super short hair. So she didn't know how to braid. She didn't know how to help me detangle it. So I just walked around like that for my whole life.
Everyone except for Joel and I are on this rocket ship ride. This used to be like the poster child of Tomorrowland, and now it's just kind of like the entry ride. And we've got Sophie and Scarlett, which are the youngest of Jennifer's kids, and we've got them on this ride, and they are very excited. Even though it looks scary to them, it's really a mellow ride. So there's something about Disneyland that just makes me like smile from ear to ear. I just like love all the joy and happiness, and like I just hope these kids are really enjoying it.
I underestimated how much fun I would have here. I thought this is like just for little kids, and that adults are just here to chaperone their kids. That is not the case. That was super fun.
It's kind of the tail end of spring break, so we were kind of expecting big crowds, but I think basically any day of the year at Disneyland is always going to be busy, and we're having a lot of fun. We just got done with Space Mountain. Everybody is really
loving life, honestly. That was so, it's like super fun because you just get to relive your inner child. So it's like, we're just having a great time. Even Leo's having a good time.
Who else is having a good time?
Woo! It's a very talkative bunch.
It's an enthusiastic bunch, but everybody's got big smiles on their face, and that's what really matters. So we're stopping for lunch. We're gonna have a nice packed lunch, nice sandwich that we made earlier at the house. And we're going on more rides. So we just made it out here to the like new Star Wars land. There's like a legit full-size Millennium Falcon. Really cool. I feel like somebody said you got to go inside, but maybe not. Anyway, we're about to go on the new Star Wars ride. This whole land is like a city out of Star Wars. And it's like spot on. I feel like I'm on a movie set. It's mind-blowing.
This is crazy. I love Star Wars. This is crazy.
Affirmative. Transport is ready. 9 Nomini shall personally see them delivered.
The new Smuggler's Run Star Wars ride was out of this world.
It's been super fun. The guys kind of split off and we're able to do a couple big roller coasters. And me and the girls went and did like a really fun little train ride and like a boat canal ride. And just kind of walked around, tried to look for princesses everywhere. They're really excited about the princesses. And now they're taking a little break. Leo hanging out in the shade and we're all in line for the Matterhorn.
Yeah.
compared to the newer roller coasters.
That one's a lot scarier because it feels like you're about to die the whole time.
Oh, they're so jerky and aggressive and abrasive. It's like a totally different experience. The new roller coasters, which are really intense, but very smooth. Anyway, I need to take a nap now. I think we've got everything in. It has been a really long day. I think everybody had a lot of fun, but I know pretty much everyone is entirely exhausted.
I wanna sleep, and I know that Leo won't let me sleep.
Another thing too is like we have this white noise machine and there's like air conditioning in this house and it's like nice and cool. We have a warm blanket. We've been sleeping so like a rock, like amazingly, but we obviously keep getting woken up to like take care of Leo, which is fine, but I just, you know, I'm looking forward to those days when we sleep through the night when our kid is 20.
It's a long time from now.
Anyway, we had a blast at Disneyland and it's been fun surprising these guys and getting everybody here and just having this cool adventure. And we've got some more stuff in store, but I think this is where we're gonna let you guys go.
It's been such a blast and more adventures to come.
If you guys enjoyed coming along on this adventure, make sure you show us by giving us a big thumbs up on today's video. Consider subscribing to our channel if you haven't already.
Thanks guys, we love you.
And we'll see you guys on the next one.
Adios.